Are you overpaying for your HVAC equipment? How do you know you're getting the best price at bid time? The only way to know is if you keep track of what you've paid for the equipment in the past, or you keep track of the quotes so you have some idea of what was quoted previously. Having an HVAC equipment cost database is critical to tracking HVAC equipment cost. This is your equipment cost database where you'll keep track of the cost of the equipment you either purchased, which is the better option, or quotes. So you'll get a lot of quotes as an estimator, so you can put those in here and it'll give you at least a large database of what equipment has been quoted at, or if you get your purchase orders from actual purchase, that's even better. So I'm going to do an example here. Let's say you got a quoted item, a 115-ton unit. Let's say you paid $8,100 for it, and it's a rooftop gas electric, right? Make, let's say this is a Daikin, right? And the model number I'll leave off. We're just using this as an example. That was a 15-ton, right? And a 15-ton, 6,000 CFM. So right away you see it's $1,200 per ton and 302 per CFM. So you just keep putting this in. The more you have in here, the more reliable your database is. Let's say we have a 10-ton unit and we paid 8,400, and it's the same thing, but this time it's from Trane. And model number we're going to leave off. This was 10 tons. That's 4,000 CFM. So you can see 840 per ton, 210 per CFM. Like I said, if you keep putting it in, let's say we purchase something. We'll put a P there for purchase that we can sort by either purchase or quoted. And we bought, let's say we bought another 10-ton unit, but this time we paid 7,500. Somebody bought it out. And let's say this was a Carrier. Right, this is, sorry, model number, tons is 10, 4,000 CFM. So you can see we paid 750, and at quote time, let's say there was 840. So you can see we are getting a better purchase than we are on the quotes. So maybe you take a little hedge on your quotes. Once you get enough data in here, you could tell the difference between what you're paying and what you're getting quoted. So let's put a couple more in here real quick. 3,100, let's say, same thing, rooftop gas electric. This time we'll say it's Lennox. All right, we'll leave the model number out. Let's say they're 3 tons this time. 3 tons is what, 1,200 CFM approximately. Let's put another 3-ton in here just for an example. Let's say this one we paid 2,800 for. Same thing, rooftop. We'll put York and we'll mix it up with all the vendors. These are just examples. 3-ton, 2,800. Oops, sorry. 1,200 CFM. And you can see the cost per ton and cost per CFM. So once you get all this filled out, over to the right here, you have additional parameters to keep track of: the energy efficiency, the type of cooling, type of condenser, whether air or water cooled, the heating source, whether it has economizer. All these things add cost to it, so it may explain why one is a higher cost per ton or a higher cost per CFM. Humidifiers, indoor, so all the accessories there will add to the cost per ton, cost per CFM. So once you get enough in here, then you're budgeting a project and you have a 10-ton unit, you just come look for all your 10-ton units. You sort this by 10 tons, and then you can see how much you've been paying cost per ton, cost per CFM. Same thing, maybe it's not 10 tons, maybe they're 3-ton units, right? So you sort all your 3 tons and you see what you've been buying them at. So that really helps on budgeting. It helps on checking your vendor to make sure you're not overpaying for what you paid in the past. And then this, you have air handlers, same thing. Put in the information, it'll give you cost per CFM. Air separators, chillers, boilers, table of contents, this will tell you what you got in here. So air conditioners, air distribution, air handlers, air separators, baseboard heaters, boilers, steam and hot water, chillers, coils, computer room units, condensers, just about everything you normally run into, fans, fan coil units, expansion tanks. This is your historical data, so it knows whether or not you have been paying too much based on the current quote, or if the quote's too high, you can take a deduct on your estimate. If you'd like to purchase this HVAC equipment cost database, you'll find a link in the description below, or you'll find a link on the website at www.mepacademy.com.